so you've bugged out. That's what this video is about. What happens next? You split town, you grabbed your stuff you could carry in a blink of an eye, and you have fled the scene, and you ran to the hills. So this is about what happens next. So you might be able to see behind me that I have a large amount of brush in the back seat of my car, sticks, small logs. I stopped along the way where it was more dry before I got high up into the mountains and collected some firewood that I knew would ignite, just to make sure that once I got there, I could start a fire. Now, a lot of people argue as to whether or not a fire is a viable option, but bottom line is, if you're gonna bug out, you show me some other way. There is no other way to bug out to the mountains and not have a fire. You will freeze to death, you will die of starvation, you have to have a fire. It's the caveman basics. Now, there's lots of ways you can work your fire to prevent people from seeing the smoke, but in the event of a mass departure from the city, then there's gonna be a lot of fires. But hopefully you're ahead of everybody else. You can stake out your favorite spot and stand your ground. And hopefully other people will not know where your bug out location is. You know, your bug out location is only gonna be as good. I mean, it can only be tested under the real conditions, because you just never know who else has scouted your area unless you own private property. So today I thought I would make this video up here in the, we're in the Three Bears Wilderness area along the Mulala River today. This is not my primary bug out location. It's just a cool place that I thought I'd come and make this video about bugging out. My bug out location is mine and mine alone. My business and mine alone. It's like your favorite fishing spot. You don't want to give it away. So anyway, we're going to make a video out here in this beautiful, pristine wilderness. And first thing we're going to do is play What's in Sage's Trunk, because whenever you bug out, one of the first things you're going to want to do, as soon as you feel like you're away from it and you've escaped successfully, is to catalog what you got away with. In other words, you're going to want to lay it all out and have a look and measure and weigh the various options, and think about setting up some kind of base camp, or at least preparing for a deeper trek into the mountains, or up, you know, further into the wilderness.
So you bugged out. So one of the first things you want to do is assess all of the items that you have. This is my EDC. This is what I carry in the winter. This is my wintertime loadout. And one of the reasons that I wanted to do this video is I need to clean out my trunk anyway, but I'm going to pull all this gear out and stage it up and show you what I have.
Here is everything that was inside the trunk. And as you can see, it's a lot of stuff. So this is everything that I had in my trunk. And I know it's hard to see, because even though it's the middle of the day, the sun's about to go behind that mountain, even though it's like only 2 o'clock, because we are up in it. So let's go through everything that we see here, starting left to right. I'll admit some of this stuff is left over from hunting season, like this full set of camouflage rain gear, and I have a non-camouflage set of rain gear right next to it. The game saw, which I struck out deer hunting, so I didn't need it, but there's a game saw and a gutting knife combo that I've never opened yet. There's a water bladder, and you can see two stainless steel bottles, a 64 ounce and a 40 ounce. They're full of water all the time. Plus my quart canteen with canteen cup and stove, it's full of water all the time. Back over here, you've got a pop-up blind for hunting, which would give you an immediate shelter if you needed to. And here is some camouflage blind material. Main purpose of having that is to camouflage the car. When you ditch the car and walk further into the mountains, you want to use natural stuff to camouflage your vehicle, but also it's good to start with some camouflage netting, and it gives you something to tie your bushes and brush in to camouflage your vehicle. So there's enough there to go all the way around my vehicle. Lightweight stuff. There is my escape and evasion bag. I won't break that out, but if I had to leave with just that, there's food, there's snares, there's yo-yos for fishing, there's, you know, snare wire and fishing gear and food in there, immediate food that gives me calories right now. Let's see, what else have I got here? Right here is a solar panel for recharging my electronics. Plus, as a part of this kit, there's a solar panel in that for recharging my phone as well, and it's also a battery backup. So I can even recharge all of this stuff from the solar panel. These are my jackets that are for me, that I keep in here. They're kind of hard to see, but there's a hat, a chamois, there's gloves, there's two coats, a big heavy cotton one and then an overcoat made of wool, which is very, it's a great coat. I should dig that out and wear it more often. It's just a lot of coat for most of the time around the valley. You can see that I'm sitting on a 10 by 12 tarp. All of this stuff is on a 10 by 12 tarp. And also there is, that's a poncho. It's, you know, it's really ancient. It's from the Cold War. It's called alpenflage, the kind of camouflage it is. But that can be a shelter by itself or a really awesome rain gear that will actually cover your backpack too. I got a 2-day supply of emergency food there in that box. Plus, I've got 1, 2, 3, 4 meals. And then there's food inside my my bailout bag, my escape and evasion bag, and my bug out bag. And here's my bug out bag. I couldn't tell you how many blades total are here. 1, 2, 3, 4. There's at least 6 knives in this kit. And then over here I've got my trekking poles, because 2 is 1 and 1 is none. Helps me walk in the woods. And then lastly here I have other people's jackets. Jackets for other folks. The big one's for my boy. That's his big raincoat. I leave it in there because we go fishing a lot. And then I have this other wool Pendleton coat there that's a little small for me, but would work for someone smaller who happened to be riding along. Sleeping bags. This one's good down to 20 degrees. That one's just a kid bag. It could use it on the ground. And everyone knows there's also a tarp inside of this kit as well. So there's just a lot of stuff here. I've got my boots that live in there all the time in case I need them, my backup boots, gas mask and filter in case the really bad stuff happens. I've got my chains in case I got to chain up and go into the mountains, jumper cables. This is for acquiring fuel if need be, or any other fluid. So it's a pump so I don't get gas in my mouth. And then this is a toolkit, basic hand tools for vehicle maintenance. For a couple of first aid kits, got a hatchet, a saw, some fat wood, and looks like binoculars. So I think that's everything in Sage's trunk. So now I know that I have the basics to set up a really nice base camp. At this point, I could start to hump this stuff out of here and pack it out once my car is camouflaged, or I might be at my location depending on, you know, the situation. I have way more stuff than you can pack. Because I want to be prepared for anything and everything, and I figure if I can get away with my vehicle, then stash my vehicle can serve as a locker. And so anyway, yeah, that's the plan. So anyway, tell me what you think. Would you feel comfortable making up a base camp out of everything that's here? I'll admit that the game saw and the pop-up blind are probably a little much. But it was left in there from hunting, along with that extra set of rain gear. But 2 is 1 and 1 is none, so I really like the overall preparedness level I have in this gear, and I'm pretty happy with what I got going on. I hope I never need any of it except for fun and recreation. All right, God save our republic. Dragon.